assistants Nick and Joe. Massage every corner of his drone. Phone with Cassette Band is on the home. But in the meantime, they'll play the greatest clips they've found.
VCR, Party Live. VCR, Party Live.
And the Melindas.
Well, hello, Melindas.
Welcome, hey everybody. It's VCR Party, the show where we watch VHS tapes. I got 11,000 of them here surrounding me. The ultimate fire hazard here. They could collapse on me at any moment. I'm joined by Nick and George and Steve. And boy, we got a good one here tonight. We got, did you get anything fun in the mail, Nick? I got some nice Christmas cards. Did you get any fun VHS or anything?
No, nothing. Oh, that's good. Elf on a shelf.
Yeah. Elf on a shelf. I don't know if this is like something that people like they sell or did they make this specifically for us? This is from a couple. For Nick. Yeah.
Well, it is
art by art by Christopher Pollard and sent by devoted Melinda's John and Karen. So thank you for that.
Wow.
And then look at Ethan and Kate and Coogan sent this one. This is a nice little Christmas card here.
Oh, that's good. The Home Alone with their cat is Kevin.
Yeah. Yep. So thank you for the cards. We got a bunch of other ones, but you know, this isn't a card show. This is a VHS show.
It is. We always like to start off with a found footage festival classic. So let's do it.
You caught me with my pants down, but no one sells carpet or waterbeds for less.
We've been doing these personalized videos, kind of like Cameo for folks for the holidays and for birthdays too. We call them Rent a Joe and Nick. And this one dug out, blew the dust off. It appeared in a montage in one of our earliest shows. We normally avoid Richard Simmons videos because they're dropping the bucket. It's been done to death. But I think the one where he involved celebrity parents is a cut above.
You could have included this in Celebrity Bullshit, too. Like, this could have been Celebrity Bullshit. Well,
that's
they're not
true.
Celebrities, though. They're not celebrities, though, are they?
Yeah, they're parents of celebrities. So
yeah,
here's Richard Simmons and the Silver Foxes. There's also some flying windows in here, so it could go in a lot of corners.
Oh, it ticks, like, four boxes.
Yeah. Remember in the blooper we have from Richard Simmons like special where he takes a woman by the lapels, he's like, come on, do it right, and he kind of swears at her.
Yeah.
Turns out it's his mom, Shirley Simmons. I didn't know that until revisiting the Silver Foxes.
I'm 75 and I feel great. Everybody, we can do it.
Farrah Fawcett's mom.
This is a lot of fun. Let's have a ball. Let's move it. Let's go.
Al Pacino's dad.
Sal Pacino.
Come on, get up out of that chair. Life is great. Live a little.
You got a lot of Jackie Stallone videos.
Well, maybe she's a celebrity here.
It'll make you feel terrific. Come on, it's good for you.
Dustin Hoffman's dad, Harry.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You ever wanted to see Dustin Hoffman's dad wearing a pastel yellow sweatsuit? Well, we got that covered for you.
That off the bucket list.
It's been off my bucket list. Yeah.
Seven back to Hawaii. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Sal Pacino. And all the Silver Foxes. Hand
they go
in hand with Richard.
They go everywhere together.
Yep. They're off to go grocery shopping. So there it is. The Silver Foxes, a found footage festival classic that we don't dig out too often.
No, it's a good one.
There's a sequel, too. Silver Foxes 2. Which
same
I don't
celebrity
think I've
parents?
Ever watched. Same celebrity parents, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
right.
We got it.
Steve, who are you selling out to today?
I'm selling out to myself. We're running low on the old requests. So please, if you guys want to buy my background, info@foundfootagefest.com. I'd love to promote whatever you have so I can support the Melindas that support us.
There we go.
Well said.
Yeah. Well done. Not a single flub. Proud of you.
We're watching for them too.
Okay, so back when we were doing quarantine classics, we started a thing called Plunkets, where people would send in unflattering photos of themselves, and it was a lot of fun. It really it kept the pandemic going, and we got to do another one of these pretty soon. But the reason we call it a Plunket is because Steve got his photo taken with Jim Plunkett, and he looked like a thumb in the photo. And then Plunkets were born. So, but one of those Plunkets that we received over email was from McKenna. And Nick, do you have that handy? This is the photo that
She called herself Grubchild, and yep. It looks like a school dancer of some sort. And there's McKenna,
AKA
who called herself Grubchild.
Yeah. And so, like, yeah, and we, I think for a long time, Grubchild was in the top three of best Plunkets. Mm-hmm. Well, fast forward 2 years later, get an email from McKenna, aka Grubchild, and said, "Hey, do you need any help around the office? I live in New York now, and yes, we need a shitload of help. This
yes,
place
we do.
This is a disaster here. We have no idea what the hell we're doing." So brought her on as a volunteer, and she's knocking it out of the park because she has excellent taste. I've showed some of the videos that she's given me mm-hmm. the last month or so, and she's so good. We're like, oh, let's just put McKenna on and have her own little segment where she can show us some of the stuff that she's found. And I don't know. I had the idea to call it Grubs Grabs. And what do you think? Is that Grubs Grabs? Yeah.
I like it, but I don't know if only McKenna can call herself Grubchild. I don't know how that works.
I know. That's what I'm worried about. But, okay. McKenna, are you there? Can you pop on here? Yeah.
Yeah. No, I'm a fan.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not everybody gets to look this bad. I'm happy to own it
for the world.
All right.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So you're cool with Grubs Grabs. I might make a I might make a graphic for next time.
Well, perfect.
Yeah. So what are some of your you're going through and you're archiving all the videos, all the new stuff that comes in, and then you have a keen eye for this. What are some hot picks this week?
Yeah. So I found two VHSs that are both bloopers. The first one is George Bush, his favorite bloopers.
Oh yeah.
And it says, see George fall, see Jerry fall, see Nixon fall, see Nancy fall. Which is kind of disappointing because I really wanted to see the food poisoning incident again, but
What happened? No vomiting on Japanese prime ministers?
Oh, that's what
yeah.
that was.
Yeah.
Shoot.
Yeah.
Not gonna do that.
Yeah.
But hold it up again. Hold it up like it kind of like because yeah there we go. We're learning. This is a new segment.
You can see the George Bush caricature there. Yeah.
There we go. Yeah. Yeah. Yep.
Perfect.
Yep. All right. Nice. All right. Okay.
So the second one is bloopers as well, and it says bloopers on the cover, but it looks more like a horrific plane accident, like. Someone, oh no, why can't I get her away?
Oh, there it is. There it
someone is. Definitely did not walk away from these bloopers. like there's a body count.
Yeah. Oh yeah, definitely. And it's on fire too.
Yeah.
It looks bent in half. Yeah, that's
are
not
there
a blooper.
Sound effects for like wah wah for each plane crash or
I hope so.
Okay. It's hosted by Roy Firestone, but I think he just did all of it.
What's it say on the Whams and Bams bloopers?
Yes, yeah, the best of Whams and Bams bloopers. And they were just selling out like after that really funny scene in Top Gun with Goose, everybody wanted a piece of the action.
The yep. hilarity continues on that blooper video.
It's a good one.
I want to see what's on that blooper. It's like a snuff film, probably.
It's Faces of Death, but the blooper version.
It's
the
snuff
FAA
bloopers.
Said it was a Wham or a Bam. They're still investigating. They have to find the black box.
So far, I mean, so far so good. So blooper, are you drawn towards bloopers? Like, do you see bloopers? Because we have a whole shelf over here of bloopers.
Oh, no. These were just like, there were just a ton in a box. I think a bloopers fan died somewhere and they sent their collection to a thrift store. I don't know.
Rest in peace.
Rest
blooper
in peace.
Fan.
Blooper fan. all right. Well, those are our Grubs, Garrett. Is that that's what you got?
Yeah, those are the
perfect.
Hits.
All right. Thanks. Perfect. I like it. And then you did the Blair Witch ones last week, and those are good ones. So
thank you.
You have a keen eye, Grubchild.
Thank you so much.
You said it's okay if we call you Grubchild, right?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Okay, good. I just got to make sure. All right. All right.
It's so cool. Bye, McKenna. It's cool to see McKenna as a grub adult now. I think that's, she grew up before our eyes.
A grub woman.
Like the larval stage of a grub.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, how about flying windows?
Yeah, let's do it.
Trevor sent this one, and it's only one flying window, but I liked the video on its own enough that I thought it was worth it. It's David Lee Roth. He called it, what did he call it? He called it, what was it? David Lee, God,
Window
why can't
Lee
I
Roth?
Remember? Window Lee Roth. God, yeah. Why couldn't I remember it? Yeah, so if you have the email subject be Window Lee Roth, I'm going to open it. And I enjoyed it. This is David Lee Roth with a flying window.
I think there's some Marx Brothers in it for me. I think there's a little bit of Fellini.
That's the director of David Lee Roth's videos describing his style.
I think there's some Marx Brothers in it for me. I think there's a little bit of Fellini.
Yeah, I'm adventurous.
Marx Brothers and
everything
Fellini.
Everything that I feel and everything I think and everything that motivates me, all the answers to all of your questions are in my songs.
Look at that. It went action. Into the clapboard after the action on Cover Story.
Action.
Window Lee Roth there. Give us some insight into the videos. And the Picasso brothers, I guess, were the video directors.
That's got to be the first Window Lee Roth of all time, right? I don't think we've had David Lee Roth in a window yet.
Yeah, well,
right?
Let me put it out there to the viewers. Can you find another Window Lee Roth? Because it's could be a new genre for us, and Lord knows we'll need them in 2023.
Should we offer like $1 million if somebody can find? We'll figure out $1 million later.
Yeah.
But if they find another Window Lee Roth, they can't make their own. It has to be like from an actual VHS tape.
This is going to be like the Pepsi Jet thing where all of a sudden we're obligated to actually give $1 million. So let's
How about a million Tapia coins? We'll do burp coins. A million burp coins. Yeah, sure. I'll start those back up again.
I think that's going to be like $700,000 still, but okay.
That's much more gettable, Steve.
Yeah.
Don't bring logic into this.
All right. Let's rock some ravioli, shall we?
Come on. Let's see your raviolis. Show us 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 your raviolis.
Well, I always like to start off with something for the holidays. We're getting closer and closer. Next week will be our holiday Christmas show here on VCR Party. But to get us in the mood, we revisit the many works of Alan Thicke, and I'm going with a classic in this week's edition of Thickmas. All right, going with one from, I think, maybe volume one of our show, maybe volume two. Joe, do you remember what When Mom and Dad Break Up is from? I think
what
that's
year, or what show it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's very early. It's like one of our first VHS tapes.
Yeah. So this is like it might have been a celebrity montage, might have been kids stuff, the montage, because it's all about kids and how to deal with divorce. And they meant well here. They tried to involve, stars that kids would love and Alan Thicke. So
can I ask you this? Has Alan Thicke been divorced before?
Yes,
does he know what he's talking about?
He's been divorced and he's a child of divorce. So he does definitely have some credentials and he talks about them.
I'm impressed that you had that answer like ready to go, locked and loaded.
I went back to the original footage to cut this together. So here's When Mom Plus Dad Break Up.
My name is Alan Thicke. On TV, I play a father. In real life, I am a father. These are my kids, Brennan and Robin. And we've gone through.
Chris Robin Thicke is now the
famous
singer. So there's a photo of him as a kid.
The confusion and hurt of divorce together. This video, When Your Mom and Dad Break Up, is made for you. So even though an older person brought it home for you to look at, you may want to watch the video by yourself. Well, that's up to you.
Would you call that sweater salmon? Is that salmon colored?
It's close. It's pink. Yeah, it's a carnation or salmon. Yeah.
And you can ask them to leave if you want to. Go ahead, tell them. Say, go on, I'd rather see it alone. Please, go on.
Yeah, go on, beat it!
Now mind your manners. That's Orko, my show-off assistant.
I mean, people talk about multiverse with Marvel and, you know, things things like that. I think we had the original one here with Masters of the Universe's Orko with Growing Pains'
Masters of the Thickverse.
That's what this is.
Yeah. There is a better way to ask than that.
There is?
There is.
How?
Orko.
Bye.
You're going to meet some other kids who've experienced exactly what you're going through. And we're all here to help each other.
You could call 911.
No, Aaron, the police can't help with this problem.
Talk to your parents. Or if you can't talk to your parents, talk to somebody else you trust. I mean, an older person like your grandpa, your aunt, or your teacher.
I first found out when I was looking out the window one day. I was watching for my mom to come home from work. And instead, she passed right by our house and headed up the street to my grandma's house. Well, I found out later my parents were going to get a divorce.
Yeah.
This is the hardest time ever. When your mom and dad are breaking up, you may not even know what's going to happen.
Don't feel bad about being mad or sad.
Now, here's the hardest lesson of all to learn when your parents break up. There is nothing you can do to bring them together. Nothing.
There's nothing you can do to bring your mom and dad back together again. Nothing.
You're starting a brand
That's
new
it.
Day.
It ends on a down note.
A-okay. 'Cause you've got your friends and family. And no matter what comes, you've always got me.
All right, he sings at the end, of course.
Wasn't the parent trap about bringing two parents together like they were splitting up and then they were like, oh, we got to bring them together? I mean, yeah, so it's possible.
Yeah, this tape is for non-twins, right?
Oh.
Yeah, you got to either be Haley Mills or, yeah.
They should have said that up yep. top.
Yep. So it is possible, but unlikely.
Yeah.
According to Orko.
All right. So so I've been on a hot streak with men who likely spend a lot of time on the toilet. And let's just get the graphic rolling right here. All right, so that's the master, Dr. Schulz. He's the master of men who likely spend a lot of time on the toilet. So this is a segment where I show videos of men who likely spend a lot of time on the toilet. And I think the man who really spends a lot of time on the toilet is probably this guy here, Santa. Don't you think?
Probably. Yep.
He looks like he's on the toilet there, doesn't he?
364 days a year.
He's got his list of naughty and nice kind of rolled up under his arm as he goes into the bathroom, and Mrs. Claus knows, do not disturb.
So, okay, so we got this one from Oddity Archive. If you don't know who he is, like look up Oddity Archive. It's so great, and he has so many great VHS and other weird stuff. So, but this one, he gave this one to us, Visit with Santa. I don't know if he got this there or if somebody else got this there from Santa Claus, Indiana, which like their whole thing, the whole city is all about Christmas. And Nick, you've been there before, right? And
in the off season for a college show, depressing place in the off season. No snow on the ground, just kind of fiberglass statues of snowmen, but brown grass.
And not a lot of vegan options, I imagine.
No. I think I had a pack of saltines that night.
So this is a Visit with Santa. So this was found in a gift shop in Santa Claus, Indiana, and there was like a rack of them. And you know, like how they'll have like keychains with a bunch of different names. Well, this had VHS tapes with a bunch of different names. This particular one was for Amber. And we've been showing this on our current tour. We're going to show it next week. We're showing a longer version. I'm going to show the short version of this. But this is one of those videos where they must have shot like a full... Steve, you probably know about this. Like they shot like a full long video that's generic, but then they punch in on the close-ups for the specific part, right? Okay. All right. So this one's specifically for Amber. Take it away, Santa, who spends a lot of time on the toilet.
The start reminds me of a Packer Christmas.
What's that?
The start reminds me of a very Packer Christmas.
Oh, yeah. Well, just wait. That might be coming up, too.
Oh, boy.
Hold
on. Holidays are officially here.
Exactly.
Oh, by golly. Come on in here. Come on over by Santa's fire and warm your hands. Oh, that was really a storm we had last night, wasn't it? Oh, it sure gets this old rheumatism working, though. But you know what? I didn't know.
Kids love
you'd
learning
make
about
it up.
Rheumatism.
Yeah, right. I had to look up rheumatism. I was like, oh, is that bad? Is that like shingles or something? Or like what's rheumatism? I think it's like joint pain.
Yeah. Gets this old rheumatism working though. But you know what? I didn't know whether you'd make it up here today or not with those roads so bad. I'm so happy that we're together.
And by the way, Amber drove, I guess.
She doesn't care about roads.
Amber's 38.
And lives in Hawaii. She's like, what? There was no snow today?
Today or not with those roads so bad. I'm so happy that we're together, Amber. Because you're very special to me. Everybody wants to know all about Santa Claus. And a lot of people want me to tell them my secrets, too. That's why I saved some of my favorite questions to answer. Just for you, Amber.
Boxers or
now
briefs?
Now we've gotten to know each other better.
Well, I'm glad you asked, Amber.
I shared some of my secrets with you, and some of those are really special secrets too.
He never talks about secrets at all. Like he never actually tells the secrets in this whole thing. So Amber must be like, what are the secrets that you told me? There are no secrets here.
I don't drive, and there are no secrets.
And some of those are really special secrets too.
Amber's because of the camera operator.
Wait, what?
Amber is the camera operator. I just figured it out.
That's what it is. He's just speaking directly to the camera operator.
Right. Make sure you get the f-stop right, Amber. We need this exposure perfect, Amber.
Special secrets, too. Because of that, Amber, I have a really big favor to ask. I want you to find someone in your family and give them a great big hug. And there's one more thing I want you to be sure and remember. Santa loves you, Amber. God bless you. And I'll be seeing you real soon.
You better believe it.
In your nightmares.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Happy Packer Christmas! Is anybody named Amber who's watching? Because that'd be kind of a cool experience.
I know a couple Melindas who are Amber. So yeah, okay. Specifically for those Ambers. Don't you ever betray me, Amber.
You look me in the eyes when I tell you this, Amber. I love you.
Don't you tell anybody about my rheumatism, Amber.
Between you and me, Amber.
That's my one secret. I have rheumatism.
I'll never be able to be insured if they find out about my rheumatism.
I think that's a good lesson for kids is have secrets with other adults that you don't know. I think that's a good thing to teach everybody.
It holds up. So watch the full version on our tour. We're on tour this week.
Tonight. We're in Columbus. And
tonight. We're in Columbus right now. And then, Cleveland and
Grand Rapids, Milwaukee, and Madison.
Yep. There we go.
Okay, this one I've been super excited about. Found this recently. It's Believer Size, and I was kicking myself because, we did the montage called the Ur-Size Montage, which is all about Jazzercise, Mouser-Size, Protector-Size, all the videos that bastardize the word exercise. And we have Praiser-Size, and we even have Blesser-Size, but we did not have Believer Size until recently. So I'm going to show a little bit of Kathy Stout and some surprise guests in this Believer Size montage. She's kind of got this this stare that Scientologists have, where they're kind of looking into your soul. Take a look.
Cool set.
Mm-hmm. Cool song.
Sing your praise to the Lord. Come on, everybody, stand up and sing one more. Hallelujah, give your praise to the Lord.
Toe tapping tournament's coming up.
March,
right around the corner.
Hi, I'm Kathy, originator of Believer Size. Follow along as we tone our bodies and center our thoughts on God for an effective, edifying workout.
You gotta sing your praise to the Lord.
A mighty big dude. Not even death keep him down. Could
hold you. She kind of flubbed there, but she said, not even death can keep him down. Talking about Jesus while doing this ridiculous exercise.
Not even death can keep him down.
Could hold you down.
Ribs in and out.
On that third day.
Do you think Jesus is behind the camera with like a headset on, like a clipboard or something? And it's just like, all right,
number
let's
one,
do this.
Take one.
Yeah, take one. Yeah,
yep. He's the director. Yep. Yeah. And camera person, Amber.
And he's like, this is perfect. This is exactly what I said in the Bible.
Yep. Work your tummies.
Angels, the light of the sky. Now reach a day. Oh, what a day that will be. Here's a warm-up that'll stretch out the Achilles, calf, and backside of your leg, including your derriere. And joining me for this warm-up is my sister Sherry.
She had to point at her sister's derriere. That must have been a little weird.
We're both Saturday Night Live characters.
And my sister Jan Hooks.
Stretch out the Achilles, calf, and backside of your leg, including your derriere. And joining me for this warm-up is my sister Sherry. Now let me see those praise hands. Stretch them out. Come on.
The eyes.
Real wide. And my sister-in-law Kathy will complete our trio.
Family affair. Sister and sister-in-law.
Come. Come. But inside my heart.
That works your praying hands. So like you're ready to pray.
Exactly.
Well, I have my Halloween costume.
It's a religious square dance, I guess, during this part. It's a hoedown.
Change me. Yeah. Keep breathing.
Jesus is behind the camera, just exasperated, just like, oh, God. All right. Yep. All right.
This is being done in my name, too? Okay. Yep. All right.
Moving on. All right. All right. What are we at?
What else? Miracle water?
Square dancing scene. All right. Let's wrap this up. Let's get out of here early.
Here we go. All the way to the top. And leap. Down. And up. That's right. Okay, sit with your legs straight out in front of you. Use your tummy muscles to sit straight.
What was on her head there?
She was doing some rowing, so that was a sailor. Sailor hat. Oh, okay. Yep. Just like in the Old Testament. Okay.
They really went for it. They really swung for the fences with Believer
yep.
Says.
And the end of this song is talking about he's a fat. So, and listen to the what the fat thing is.
Fat baby.
Yep.
And then
so
she
does
her
a pacifier, or sucking her thumb.
Oh no, I remember reading about that in Philippians.
Yep.
Yeah.
So for more information, it's in Plano, Texas, Believer Size by Kathy Stout, Kathy with an I.
Yeah.
And
do you know
man,
what suite they're in? What suite are they in? That'll be in one of George's trivia.
Yeah, I'd be like, Jesus, I don't even remember Believer Size.
I don't know. Yeah. It must be so weird when you have like a religious themed business when it fails. Like it's not just the marketplace that doomed you. It's like God also thinks your product
exactly.
is terrible.
Well, you got to pivot. It's like the doomsday people. Actually, it wasn't today that the world was going to end. I misinterpreted it. So there's always the goal
no,
to keep moving.
They never
you
admit
wanted me to struggle.
They never admit failure on it though, right? They're just like,
no.
It's got to be something else, right?
Well, Job went through like 10 franchises before he struck gold, right?
Yeah, Chick-fil-A's, right?
Right.
Like that's what he, yeah.
With his franchise, take this Job and shove it. What do you got, Joe?
Well, we hinted
it's an employment at this. Agency.
All right. Okay. Yeah. Temp agency kind of a thing.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So this is another holiday tradition that we have here at VCR Party. It's the ultimate Packer fantasy. And each year I try to add on to it a little something. So this is something, I think it was like 2004. This is like, wow, this is, I'm doing the math in my head. 18 years old.
Oh my
we
God.
Made this 18 years ago.
Wow.
So my, our buddy Mark, who we knew from college, he and I lived in Minneapolis at the time and we had just won a film festival. We won $400 for a short film that we made. We took the $400 and we decided to spend it on a green screen thing, like a green screen short film called The Ultimate Packer Fan to See, where Mark would dress up as like this flamboyant elf man, green and gold Packer fan, just kind of a generic Packer fan, and he went into this. We came up with this long backstory for it. We wrote up the script and we shot the whole thing. We spent all $400 on it, and then we never did anything with it. We sat on it because we were, I don't know, the internet was barely invented at the time. So we're like, what are we even going to do with this? Like, we're going to, you know, I think we wanted to sell it at Packer Games. I think that was the idea, was we sell DVDs at Packer Games. Never came to fruition. So this has been sitting on a hard drive for so long, and the last few years I've been playing it, and I think people like it. I think people enjoy it. This year I added something to it. Zach from Chicago, he was a fan of it, and he wrote some lyrics for it that would explain the story as it went along. That was one thing I always wanted to do, but again, this is such a back burner project, I never even thought to do anything. So he just sent it to me, and then I had the idea, oh, let's get Harvey Sid Fisher to read this, because Harvey Sid Fisher has a great like voice, and he does some voice acting too. And last summer I brought it up to him, and he said yes, and I offered him some money, but there was just so many hoops to jump through with Harvey Sid Fisher. He was just like, now what exactly is this? And I didn't know how to explain it to him, because it's nothing. So
the pitch you just gave us was perfect. That didn't work for him.
Well, no, it's not that easy with Harvey. So you guys are easy. Harvey,
what is it, a Packer elf of some kind? All right,
flamboyant elf, you say? Okay, I'm in.
Slideshow, Mal.
So yeah, so he hasn't said no. It's just like, I just, you know, do I want to go over to his house and record this and explain everything? And it's going to take some timing, so I just recorded it myself. So this is a temp track I put in. This is a rough cut. The audio's bad. Like, I just recorded it on my phone. I just like temped it in to where it's probably going to be. But thank you, Zach, for putting this together. It really helps tell the story. And this is when we're shooting this, for some reason we were like, let's have a scene where the ultimate Packer fan combs the hair of a long-haired man and then like shampoos his hair in a sink. And we did that, and I can't find that footage anywhere. That would be gold. But I do have the still from that. And so that's
probably what's keeping Harvey Sid on the fence. If you had the footage, you're probably in.
But look, is the long-haired man in here or not?
I'm sure Harvey Sid's watching. So Harvey Sid, I'll get that footage to you. All right, here it is. The ultimate Packer fan to see with my tracks temped in. Thank you, Zach.
Production company.
Yep. These are all inside jokes too. Johnny Ritchie, all inside jokes. That's Mark. Mark, by the way, is the guy who did Kenny Strasser, the Yo-Yo Expert.
And this is what we do in the shadows now, but
yeah, exactly.
Gotta start somewhere.
Yep.
Packer Town Hall.
The ultimate Packer fan to see.
But I put a little reverb on that.
Cool.
Once upon a time in the frozen tundra, sat a hobo on a milk crate full of wonder. He was down on his luck, didn't rhymes. Have a buck. And
what's that?
I didn't realize it was going to rhyme. It just took me by surprise.
Yeah. And okay. If you could, just please don't step over the,
sure.
The lyrics. Yeah.
Full of wonder. He was down on his luck, didn't have a buck. And had not a blanket to sleep under. When all of the sudden what should appear but Santa, except without his reindeer. With a wink Santa sent a powerful spell, though, that turned that old hobo into the fanciest fellow. Thank you, dear Santa, which returned a new wink and a mustache that twirled and swirled with a slink.
What do you guys think about my read so far?
Very good.
Nailing it.
Very broad.
I also had another idea.
Yeah?
If Harvey Sid continues to play hardball, you know, George knows Mr. Nasty. Have you thought about him doing the read?
Yep.
Oh!
And he would love to meet you.
Jack Mulcahy, another potential actor we know. Jason Griffith.
What I want Burl Ives. Like, I want, like, an old man voice is what I want. That's why I was thinking Harvey Sid Fisher. But I think Mr. Nasty could actually be good. He'd probably do it for free, too, right? Like, Harvey Sid Fisher doesn't work for free.
I'm not sure.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll
grease
find
the
out.
Wheels.
We'll find out. Next time I'm in LA, we'll get this done. Maybe. Probably not. All right, here we go.
A Packer fan, he became a Packer fan with a new name. David Packerman, he would be called David Packerman once and for all.
We decided to give him a name.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
David Packerman. So that would be his name once and for all. Wait, by the way, Mark did all the music for this too. This is
yes,
Mark did all himself. It's genuinely good music, I think.
My favorite's the rap.
Oh yeah, it's coming up. Don't worry. 10 minutes from now, it'll be here.
He danced and pranced and had all he desired until he ran out of gas and soon became tired. He snapped his fingers and like cheese to a mouse, he found himself relaxing inside the Packer bathhouse.
He's in the Packer bathhouse now. We need some
An enchanting music. Dream suddenly took hold. David Packerman was macho and fancifully bold. Running at full speed, he would not yield until he scored a touchdown on the football field.
We'll need to put the field behind this, I guess, right?
That's yeah, part exactly. Of the
to-do list. Yeah.
I'm just tired thinking about like all the
chroma key,
the chroma key stuff that I'd have to do with this. Yeah,
you guys must have quite a costume budget. I mean, this is just
we spent a lot of time at the Goodwill. We went around to all the Salvation Armies. We got the perfect outfit.
Perfect football.
And by the way, we had to go with blue screen on this one, chroma blue, because there's so much green that he's wearing. So there's a little inside tip.
And as he celebrated, he saw in the sky. Why, it was he himself flying on by.
Big clouds going by.
They waved at each other and had a good laugh. Then he awoke from the dream he had in his bath.
Okay. We're not done yet.
Later that night, after being fully refreshed, he came upon Packer Village's annual dance contest.
Oh, no.
So he snapped, and with that, he entered the game and blew a kiss to the judges for a shot at some fame. But then someone else had appeared on a whim, and it was absolutely crucial to prance harder than him. He tapped and he snapped and jumped up and scrapped, while his yellow opponent just scoffed and talked trash. No matter, thought David, his dance skills could top his opponent's dance moves known as the hip-hop. He rapped and he tapped and he snapped with grace while shaking his arms quickly and shuffling his face.
Shuffling his face.
But the judges were moved, and as David would see, it was the rap tapper who received the trophy. It didn't matter when all in the end... They were, after all, the very best friends. And he snapped his fingers, and to celebrate, he ordered two drinks to decide his fate. But one of each color, which one would be keen? He decided it would be the one that is green.
We need music under this.
No, you don't. Builds tension.
But ho, what's happening now? He was suddenly growing and growing, but how? He would grow so big he couldn't believe his height. He was so tall he was out of sight. So now he was grown and was ever so tall, but he didn't want this. He wanted to be small. So his fingers he snapped, hoping his size would be sapped. But alas, nothing happened. He was bigger than his pap.
He's bigger than his pap.
It is making a lot more sense now.
Yeah.
I mean, doesn't it read like a Burl Ives kind of a
Dr. Seuss or
yeah,
Dr. Frosty the Snowman.
As far as Packer fantasies go, this is the ultimate one.
This is the ultimate Packer fantasy, easily. So that's part one. Part two will be next week. Stay tuned for that.
Okay, so more Christmas highlights coming up next week.
Yep.
Okay, that's Show Us Your Raviolis.
Show us your raviolis. Show us your raviolis. Show us your raviolis.
Now we're going to do the next segment we call How to Watch Cyber Videos on the Internet.
Got it.
Nailed it.
This is the segment where we show off videos that we found on the internet and not on VHS tape. Let me just go first with Huntsville Rewind, our buddy in Huntsville, Alabama, who has been digitizing old things taped off TV from the general Huntsville area for years now. And this one just came across just when I think the well is tapped for Christmas. This is Toby's Toys.
When you step into the ring with Toby's Toys, make sure your prices are tagged right. Toby bounces high prices off the ropes and keeps the competition on the mat. If you're looking for the best match in town, then put Toby's Toys in your corner. Team up with Toby to body slam high prices and pin down so-called discounts. Toby's Toys will always count the competition out. Toby's Toys, a winner every time!
God, I miss when local commercials, they didn't have access to green screens. It wasn't 16:9 aspect ratio. You had to, if you wanted a Kapow special effect, you just had to make it in Magic Marker and put it up.
Yeah.
Don't make them like this anymore. So thank you to Huntsville Rewind. Give them a follow on Instagram to see more gems like that.
Good stuff. All right. George, what do you got?
Well, last week's corner was a winner. So it's time to watch a few more public service announcements that are more disturbing than they are helpful.
All right.
Free PSAs.
They asked me to come, both of them. I'm not on anyone's side. I'm in the middle. Yeah, the man in the middle. Between Arab and Israeli, Greek and Turk, Indian and Pakistani. Keeping them apart so the world stays together. I'm the UN, and I'm a soldier at war for peace. The man in the middle. Without me.
That was insane, right?
I mean, yes. What?
Yes!
Truly. Truly bonkers.
What wow. The fuck?
And yeah, I mean, for all the people who believe the UN is like some black helicopter organization, like that, I don't think that dispelled any of the weirdness.
That made it worse.
Right.
Wow. I want to know who directed that. I wonder if they got like John Carpenter to do that, or like Wes Craven or somebody.
It's the same technology as like a Nightmare on Elm Street 4, where they had like giant latex sheets and people mm-hmm. like tearing yeah. at them. I love it. But a weirder one is an anti-smoking animated commercial that I think makes smoking look really cool.
Out of the land of the tobacco plant,
yep.
come a tall, hard-riding, long, lean bloke. Feared by his friends and enemies alike. Called by the name of...
Thumbnail.
Johnny Smoke. Johnny Smoke.
Thumbnail.
Johnny Smoke.
Johnny Thumbnail.
Where you were heading, Johnny Smoke? How many silos will be empty tonight? How many men will lie still beneath the sky? How many tears will be shed because of you?
He's a badass.
How many
cigarette
more
riding a horse.
Die? Out of the land of the tobacco.
That's a real man.
Come a tall, fast-growing, long, lean bloke. Feared by his friends and enemies alike. Feared by all who come to know the name of Johnny Smoke.
Wow, great song, too.
That did not work for what they wanted, what they intended. That did not work for what they intended.
And just
like he was Clint Eastwood.
Yeah, no, it sounded a little bit like James Earl Jones or something, but mm-hmm. but that
but,
sort
no,
of
no. But Johnny
gravitas.
Smoke is essentially a man with no name coming in. You know,
a man with no filter.
Stranger.
Yeah,
I'm ready to try to start smoking again. That did it.
Well, remember when we did that? Remember Nick when you attempted to smoke?
Yeah, it was on Patreon and. I had my window open, but it still smelled like smoke for a good probably 3 days in my house.
We got to do one outdoors because I feel like you were timid with the cigarette. You were like, and you're like,
Joe will dress like Johnny like, Smoke and he'll attempt to.
Nick was like, I have a headache already. Like he took two puffs. He's like, I have a headache.
Well, I do. I've never smoked before.
That's not what happens, though, when you have a cigarette.
Happened to me.
Well, you're riding on cloud nine after a cigarette. That's what happens.
Not if
just
you're not
one
used
quick
to
quick one. One more.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
It's Peter Weller with a not very good line reading.
Ooh.
What's bugging you, Murphy?
Drugs. Drugs bug me.
Hi. That was Nancy Allen and me. I'm Peter Weller, the guy behind that mask. If you're a kid, please listen for a second. How do you keep away from drugs? They're everywhere, sometimes even at home. But there is one place you can go that is 100% drug-free. No pot, no pills, no crack, no smack, no coke, no exceptions. The Boys and Girls Club. It beats the streets. No kidding.
FBI absolutely, put that out.
Absolutely no pauses between sentences. He had to go someplace.
Yeah. Also, it would have been more effective if he were RoboCop saying that. Peter Weller, kids are just like, okay.
Drugs.
Okay, Peter Weller.
Drugs bug me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping for an Ed 209 cameo too, but what are you going to do?
Smoking Ed 209.
Whose turn is it now? Steve, why don't you go?
Sure. So this week I have a two-parter. It's a commercial for the Reggie Candy Bar from 1978. And if you don't know, Reggie Jackson famously said, I should be put on a candy bar. And so the Clark Company heard, and they put him on a candy bar. And here is the commercial that he used to sell it. And then I'll follow it up with a what happened once they gave it away for free.
All right.
Listen. An outstanding World Series. Three home runs in one game.
Now that was a day I'll never forget. And it helped me to get my own candy hit. Reggie, with a rich caramel center, lots of fresh roasted peanuts, and a super chocolatey covering. Reggie, the candy they named after me. Mmm. Reggie, you taste pretty good.
Like cannibalism.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so, the next year, they gave it away. It was the first opening day at Yankee Stadium, and this was right after he hit three home runs. So Reggie, once again, hits a home run, and what do you think happens? But the entire crowd litters the field. It takes them over 15 minutes to clean it up. They have to stop.
They throw out the wrappers?
No, they just threw candy bars just directly onto the field. And you just see they've just got them everywhere. Just people are being pelted. They had to clear the field.
Yeah, come to
spend this time.
The legacy of the Reggie Bar.
You just have to treat sports audiences like they're kindergarten classes, right?
Or I mean,
animals. Like, or animals. Like, yeah, they're just the worst. They're just the worst. You can't give them anything. Otherwise, they're going to litter it on the field.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
first,
boy.
You know, first at bat. For him.
Oh, the worst. All right, my cyber video is it's our cyber video. It's a video that we uploaded to the internet. We got this answering machine from Answerphone in Minneapolis, the good folks at Answerphone. So he came to the office. Eric came to the office and he said, I have this incredible answering machine you have to hear. And he played it for me, and I was just like, oh, this is gold. And this is real. He found it, like, he finds all these at like thrift stores and stuff. And I played it, and I added some Google images to it, and I have an update about this. Oh. But let me first play. I haven't played this. I don't think I played this in a year or so.
Oh,
over a year.
I love this one. I know immediately what it is.
Yeah, this is.
I'm so excited.
It has a name now too. It's called the Dorothy recording.
Oh, so good.
So this is the Dorothy recording. That's what Answerphone calls it. So here it is. The Dorothy recording. This is all real. 100% real.
Isn't there a plug-in or something?
I don't. I never looked at it because they just hooked it up for me. And,
yeah.
You know, I was going to tell you about my experience on Friday.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, well, the lady was going to go to Cubs shopping and then to Walmart. So she took me to Walmart and she said, I'll pick you up in an hour because I have to go to Cubs.
Right.
So they had azaleas there for a good price, so I was looking at them and picking them out. And then I hurried and got my stuff, and I started to sort of get my diarrhea.
Oh, no.
So I had to run in the store a couple times. But anyway, I was sitting on the bench waiting for her. So I thought I seen her car pull up. So I kind of looked, and she seen me looking, you know. So she rolled down the window and motioned for me. So I had two carts, so I tried to get out with my carts. When she seen I had two carts, she helped me. Well, that ain't the story. Anyway, I got home.
Favorite part.
And Then the diarrhea really hit me at 3. Mm. So I was sick, and then I thought, well, I'm going to get in my nightgown, get all ready for bed, and I went to bed, and I had got the television in my bedroom, so I put that on and was looking at it, and all of a sudden, I thought, my good Lord, did I poop in the bed? Mm-hmm. So I flies out of bed and runs in the bathroom. And I was shocked. My bathroom, or my nightgown, was full of red blood. Mm. And after I got done going on the toilet, I looked, and it was just all bright red blood. The whole water was full of blood. So then I grabbed a towel and put between my legs. I didn't know what to do, so I run to the phone. Anyway, I got my scattered rugs in the bedroom. Blood all over everything. Mm. So then, Judy panicked, so I didn't know what to do, so I called Gary. And then he was in the middle of having Darren's birthday party. Mm. So he says, gee whiz, he says, are you bleeding bad? And I says, well, yeah, it's running down my legs. And he says, call Judy right away. Have her come over. So then he hung up. So then the phone rings back. He told Debbie what was happening. That's his wife. So he says, Debbie and Tracy's on their way over. Have you got the door unlocked? So they...
That's it. That's how it ends. We'll never know how... I mean, obviously she's okay because she's making the phone call. So everything was fine for Dorothy. But... this Dorothy recording really took off, and so WFMU is doing. I think that Eric knows a guy at WFMU. Ken. Ken has a show called I think it's called Ken's Program on WFMU, and on January 4th, he's going to do 3 hours of remixes of the Dorothy recording. He must have been playing this recording on the show for a while. They have their own Melinda mixers. And sent him in mixes. And so now on January 4th, he's going to do 3 hours of remixes. We got to meet this Ken guy.
Absolutely.
Because I feel like we have enough, like, maybe we could do a Ken program for Jim's Coins in Hilldale, you know, because we got so many of them.
Getting close,
We should become friends with Ken. So anyway, so I heard one of the songs, and it's genuinely very good. It's called, I don't know what the song's called. It's from the Dorothy recording. And by the way, our Melinda mixers, you should make a recording of this and send it to Ken's Program. I think it's easy to find. It's WFMU, Ken's Program.
We got some good Melinda mixers, so I think they're up for the challenge.
I think that they could submit some quality stuff here. So here's one of the remixes that I heard, and I genuinely love the song. This is only 1 minute. It's like a 4 minute song, but listen, here's the Dorothy remix.
Diarrhea really hit me at 3.
Like that. Wow. It's a genuinely great song.
Easily the best Ministry song I've ever heard.
I love it.
It is. So like that's January 4th, Ken's Program. And I will promote that. We don't even know Ken, but I do love WFMU. I contribute $10 to them a month because I love what they do. Their app is fantastic. It's a free app. You can, there's so many like great, so like the live show is great, but they have so much great They're doing like basically the bullshit that we do, you know, finding weird stuff and doing
the music version of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Love that remix. They're off to a good start. And that wraps up Cyber Videos for this week. I think we have time for a handful of nice things for the holiday. We're getting quite a few of them. So here's nice things. We've got a Patreon, patreon.com/foundfootagefestival. You can sign up at any level. You get access to our exclusive like Discord, like which is a great community where people chat, they share videos, and they also share some art. So I have some art to show from Karenna here. Did some VCR party fan art, and I think this is pretty cool. Pretty good likenesses.
Oh, that's good.
Joe, your hat says Pit Wisps. Mine says Elf. Oh,
I want a hat that says Pit Wisps.
What does yours say, Steve? I can't quite.
Insert sport here.
Insert sport here, of course. Okay, yeah.
That'd be a great hat for you, Steve. That like, just like with, yeah, parentheses, like sport thing here. Yes.
Well, the other one that we got is like, I occasionally will get emails. I don't know if you do, Joe, but people say like, I saw somebody who looks exactly like Nick. And I'm always like, yeah, okay. It's a guy with an auburn beard and wears a hat. All right.
No. It's bright red, like screaming, like on fire red beard like you have.
Right.
And yeah. Yep. And wearing a hat and yeah.
Well, Cinematic in England sent this one in, and I have to admit this one, it's almost like an AI generated thing because it's so close, even down to the demeanor. This is from a Henry VIII show.
Zoom in on that.
But I think that's even the expression that I give most people that I encounter.
It is. And it actually looks like your elf coat that you made a couple years back.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. Yeah. But
looks exactly like your elf coat. You should do a side by side of that.
Well, credit where credit is due because. Not a lot of these folks that people send me actually look like me, but that one is damn close. So thanks, Cinematic.
I got that email too, and I looked at it, and I was like, "Oh, he did some Photoshop stuff here." I thought he Photoshopped it. Yeah,
but that's the real thumbnail.
You look exactly like Henry VIII, Nick.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Uh huh. Yep. And you rule VCR party just like Henry VIII did.
Eight wives.
All right. Oh, so we did a show in Arlington, Virginia a few nights ago, and that's always a fun place. The Arlington Draft House, one of our favorites. And Farmer Dan came out. Farmer Dan, regular Melinda contributor. Here's a photo of us shaking hands.
We're in an Utz potato chip shirt.
Potato chip?
Potato chip sweater of some sort.
I know. Look at that. The crab chips. Yeah, it's a nice thing. Look at that firm handshake right there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, look at my thumb's turning pink.
Yeah, there. It's a firm grip.
But look at below. He's handing me over something. What he's handing me is a nice thing. A couple nice things. He gave us some shirts. Now, there's a video that we played a few years ago. It was in one of our shows. I don't know if it was one of our shows. Maybe it was a web video. We played it on VCR Party very early. It was called
What I Want.
Yeah.
David Cross gave it to us. And it's a new age seminar about self-actualization that never actually, this was supposed to become a video, but this is just the raw footage. See if you spot something that is a nice thing in it.
Just hear it out loud. What do you want?
I want to be a space for who I really am. Mm. I want to be able to be my essence all the time.
So, wait, keep it up. Keep it up. We in a very early VCR party, somebody sent us a Running Wild shirt just like that, but it was, mm-hmm. it was pinkish red. And we still have it. Like it's on a shelf somewhere. It's in my box back here. But Farmer Dan, when he handed me over that nice thing, Nick, now you can go to full. Take a look here. Let me just, I got to see what I'm showing here. He gave us the purple one. He found the purple Running Wild shirt.
And I thought it was wolves on it, but it turns out it's a canoeing. That's whitewater rapids. I take it, right?
Yeah, and we called the phone number and we asked them about it, and they had no idea what the hell we were talking about, as usual.
Yep.
So that was one nice thing that he had given us, the actual purple shirt of this. I'm going to show you this letter first that was included with this next thing. It's a letter of authentication. Authentication. Mm-hmm. That doesn't sound like a real word, but authentication says, congratulations on your purchase of an item from the estate of Roderick Toombs, a.k.a.
Yeah.
Rowdy Piper.
Yes. This is from the estate of Rowdy Piper. This letter confirms the item is from Roddy Piper's personal collection, and if the item is signed, it is authentic signature. It is his authentic signature. What? What does that mean? Anyway, item description. Fighting fit t-shirt worn by Roddy Piper. I'm going to show this first before I show the shirt, but take a look. You see that? You got your ears on? All right. Look at this. An actual shirt for fighting fit. Nick, you showed this video, right?
Yeah, I've shown it a couple times. This is Rowdy Roddy's exercise video with a bunch of kids in it. And yeah, it's a classic.
Wow.
Yeah, this is a shirt that he actually wore. Like, he had on his back. And I'm smelling it now. And it smells like fabric softener. But but he sweated in this thing, right? Like, this is like his DNA is in this, right? Roddy Roddy Piper's DNA is actually in this.
Yeah.
So
you can clone him.
Thank you, Farmer Dan. Like, I don't know. What size is it? Double XL? No, it's just a regular old large. I mean, I could fit into this.
Fit you.
Is it sacrilege to, like, wear the shirt? Should it not be worn? Should we hang this up?
No, you got to wear it. I think you got to wear it to have his legacy live on.
Okay.
Well, go to England and wear it. Where he filmed Fighting Fit.
Yeah, for some reason.
Yeah. So there it is. Thank you, Farmer Dan, for this very nice thing. Maybe the nicest thing.
Christmas came early. Thank you, Farmer Dan.
Yeah, nice work. Yeah.
All right. And then, Joe, you've been wearing it, but I haven't been talking about it. The Waterbed Creations shirts are here.
Yes. So if you order one. So this is Brad from Iowa. He got obsessed with a commercial that was his earliest childhood memory. And during the pandemic, he tracked down the commercials and the guy who owned Waterbed Creations. And he made this shirt. Well, no. He found this shirt from the Waterbed Creations guy. And we put them up for t-shirts that are hard to explain. And they have arrived. So if you ordered one, they're in the mail. And but I don't think we made enough to, like, say that we can continue selling them. So don't buy any, because this is it. So whenever we do these t-shirts that are hard to explain, buy them immediately, because this is actually it's iron-on. It's all iron-on. And so this is our first time doing an iron-on. It feels like a shirt from, like, the 1980s. Like, they did, our t-shirt manufacturer did a really good job. So Waterbed Creations, it's in the mail. This is same color, same everything, soft cotton. So
fantastic.
Nice thing.
Thank you. That is a great way to close out nice things.
Okay, just a couple more things. We have a brand new website, foundfootagefest.com. It's our website, like, hadn't been updated since, like, 1997 before. Like, finally, we have an updated website, and there's everything there. There's our store there, but there's also videos you can watch. There's all sorts of cool things. It starts with a video up top.
Patreon everything. Link. We got
it's
tour.
One-stop shopping for all of our tour dates, for everything. Also, there's Easter eggs on there. Like, you can go through and, like, find, like, there's some hidden links. I don't want to give too much away, but, like, there's some hidden things within the website. Who put it together for us? It was what do they call themselves?
Oh, Glenn and Company.
Yeah, I wrote it down somewhere. we have to give them a shout out.
Yeah, but it looks great. You can buy all this stuff that we have in stock. Everything's on here. Quick links to all our YouTube shows, etc., and all our social links.
Brand Science. They're the ones who put this together for us. Thank you, Brand Science. And super good job. And everything's there. Foundfootagefest.com. What else do we have? We have 20% off everything at the store. Just for the holidays, last minute request. If you're too late to order anything, like if the, you know, Christmas is coming and you can't order it in time, we have last minute gifts that don't require shipping, like gift cards, digital downloads. You can get a rent to Joe and Nick. We were talking about earlier where you rent Nick and I to do a personalized show for somebody. There's last minute gifts there. So foundfootagefest.com has all that stuff.
Yep. Check that out. Joe, you mentioned we are in Columbus right now through the power of time travel. We're just probably have wrapped up our show at the Wexner Center, but tomorrow night we're in Cleveland. Lenora from Midnight Rental is opening for us on this whole stretch. Then on Thursday, we are in Grand Rapids, Michigan, then Milwaukee, and then Madison to kind of close out our holiday tour. So come see us there. And I also want to mention that Saturday Morning Cartoons, we got a VHS-only cartoon based on Pogs called The Legend of the Hawaiian Slammers. So Scott from Strange Tapes, who is a Pog expert, I don't think you'd mind me saying that, is going to take us through the Hawaiian Slammers.
Driver 23 has arrived in Blu-ray and the Atlas Moth, both films on one, two movies on one. It's the American movie of music. It's a documentary. It's one of the best rock docs of all time, in my humble opinion. But also, it's a slick Blu-ray because we included a booklet. Look at this graphic design. And Rolf, the director, had this tribute to Dan Cleveland, who's the subject of it. And there's all these great photos in here. And our buddy Eric put together. Look at that. Here's the Blu-ray right here. Look how cool that looks. Like that,
wow, I haven't
it looks
seen
like,
that yet.
No, it looks like one of Dan Cleveland's like CDRs that he would make for his shows. That's what we styled it after. So, yeah, that's all. That's available on foundfootagefest.com, and pick one up today.
We're having a holiday contest. So Joe, of course, got Pam Cap on his vanity plate because of the video about how to do magic tricks with the cans from Pam Cooking Spray. It's a long explanation, but suffice to say, viewers of the show.
Everything is a long explanation.
Viewers of the show have been sending in their own decorated for the holidays Pam caps. And we got a good one here. Make me an offer. This is, of course, the Price Master.
Yes.
In Pam cap form. They've put a little gold mask on, put it in a little trophy. And man, this is good. So this is.
Yeah. I think that's our most insane like ask of our Melindas, you know, like the decorate a Pam cap. Like,
everybody's got one.
That's the most. Yeah.
That one was from Sergeant Gorgeous. So send them in next week. Next Friday is the deadline. info@foundfootagefest.com. Anything else going out?
We have a new Bastard Tapes that just came out right now. You can listen to it. It's all Christmas bullshit songs. Bastard Tapes is curated by Tim Harrod from Conan O'Brien. He was a Conan writer, and he's still at The Onion. It's so well curated, and it's just all bullshit Christmas songs. So,
it's good. This is one of my favorite episodes, and an almost heartwarming message at the end. Almost. So give that a listen. It's great.
What one last thing. Mark Borchardt, Dundee Project, a project that we produced. We had like 50 DVDs left of the Dundee Project. Finally, he's behind the camera, and he's making this documentary about alien. It's like a UFO convention up in northern Wisconsin, and it's so good. But he autographed the last 50 DVDs, and I think we have 25 left. So if you want one of those, hop onto foundfootagefest.com. All right, okay. I'm tired of pitching stuff. There's too much
stuff. Holidays.
It's the holidays. We got to pitch shit. Yeah. That's how it goes.
But so anyway, we will see you next week for our Christmas show here on VCR Party. What are we going to go out on?
Let's see. Oh, Bob from Hull, The Dead Past, regular contributing Melinda. He judged one of our toe tapping tournaments. Great musician. Listen, find The Dead Past on Spotify, Instagram. It's so good. And so I don't know why he did this. He said, I remixed episode 229 and I also made a video.
Okay.
So what episode are we on now?
244. Yeah.
Okay. So 229. I don't know. He must have taken a shine to.
Okay.
And he decided to remix stuff from that episode. And so, it weighs heavily on the May guy. Mm-hmm. So, but it's so good. Again, genuinely great song. So thank you, Bob from Hall, The Dead Past. And here's the thing. If we had been prepared, we could have done better.
Be right back right after these words.
info@foundfootagefest.com if you want to sell out. My nose isn't full of yuck anymore.
I can run, I can jump, I can dance and sing. Believe in yourself and do anything.
Okay, now we'll work with Christopher.
Thank you.
I'm from America.
When we return, Dr. Sellner will complete the bunion surgery.
Yes, those are his pajamas he's wearing.
All right, I gotta go.
That's all. That's it.
Let me see that one.
Rocks are done. Gotta sleep. Bye.
That's it. That it done.
We did our best. If we'd been prepared, we could have done better.
What do you think about Bibra?
About what?
In A.
My nose is for yuck anymore.
Ooh. That's all I'm doing.
Cheerio.
Tinkerbell.
We'll be right back right after that.
And Kurt Polster, the real great guy.
Night, night.
Goodbye.
Jim's coins in Hilda.